The last time we saw the shoe, it was two presidents ago. My favorite play, Allen Iverson, he was still in the NBA. I think it was around the late part of his Denver Nuggets career, or he was either on the Pistons by that point. I can't quite remember, so it's been a long time since we've seen this shoe. It originally released in 1997, it came back in 2009, and we haven't seen it since. So a lot of people have been waiting and waiting for this OG colorway to return, and finally, at the end of October, it's back. And it's a great way to cap off the month. Air Jordan 12 Cherry. Now I will be honest, because I will not fake the funk. Just because it's an OG colorway, just because a lot of old sneakerheads are waiting for this shoe to come back, I'll be honest, I've never been a huge Jordan 12 guy, so I wasn't like dying for this shoe to come back. I only go for Jordan 12s when it's a colorway that I really like. The Cherry's a very nice colorway, very nice in hand. Michael Jordan did wear this shoe in the 96-97 NBA season, but yeah, it is what it is. It was never a shoe that I was like yearning to come back. And this shoe, it is dropping on October 28th for $210. And this shoe, I believe there was a shock drop on sneakers a few weeks ago. Maybe I'm confusing that with another shoe. I can't quite remember. I'm getting things mixed up. I've been on a two-week vacation, so I'm kind of out of it. I'm still super jet lagged. Right now, I literally feel like I'm about to fall asleep mid-recording this video, but if my memory serves me correctly, I think there was a shock drop. But October 28th is the official release date on sneakers in the United States. And quick fun fact, the Jordan 12 was designed by Tinker Hatfield, legendary designer, and he was inspired by Japan, which was nicknamed the Land of the Rising Sun. So you see that stitching pattern on the upper sole that is inspired by the rays of a sun. And another fun fact, back in 97, when the Jordan 12s first released, it was the first year that Nike officially spun off Air Jordan, so they created Jordan Brand into its own kind of company. So the Jordan 12 was the first signature Jordan shoe to be part of Jordan Brand. And the upper sole of this shoe, it is leather, primarily in that white leather base layer. And the leather on the shoe, it's decent, it's not the nicest, it's not premium. A little disappointing because a lot of people are looking forward to this shoe. But yeah, nice leather, not great. And then on the mudguard, a very distinct feature of the Jordan 12, comes in that faux lizard texture. It is leather, but the texture is that faux lizard texture. And in a vacuum, I've never really loved that faux lizard skin texture. If I had to choose, I do prefer when they change that up and make it like suede, premium suede, like the off the top of my head, like the Jordan 12 Arma Menier. That had really nice suede in this part, so it replaces that faux lizard texture, but I get it. It is part of the DNA of the Jordan 12. And another part that is part of the DNA of the Jordan 12, it is that Jumpman right under the mudguard. And another very distinct feature of the Jordan 12, it is the 2-3 that is spelled out on the tongue of the shoe. So the 2, it is in letters, and the 3, it's just a number. And what I do appreciate about this tongue is that it is the same leather on the tongue as well as the upper sole. So a lot of times you see on Jordan shoes, the tongue would be like this synthetic, plastic, crappy leather. On the shoe, however, it seems like the leather is uniform throughout the tongue and the upper sole. And the top four eyelets, despite it looking kind of like metal in images, it is just plastic. So cheap kind of feeling to it. Doesn't feel too good. Not sure why they don't just go with metal. Maybe it's a weight savings measure. Don't know why. For $210, I think they can spare a little bit of money, a little bit of budget. They're giving us some metal eyelets at the top. Just make it a bit more premium. But no. We're asking for too much. And then on the booty of the shoe, again, a very distinct feature of the Jordan 12. I generally don't like pull tabs, but the Jordan 12 pull tab is very unique, very distinct. It has the word Jordan going up, and right under it, the words quality inspired by the greatest player ever. And I know a lot of young fans, a lot of young NBA fans, you're gonna argue that LeBron is now the GOAT. To me, MJ will likely always be the GOAT until the end of my days. My favorite player is Allen Iverson, but objectively speaking, I do think MJ is the GOAT. So the words on this pull tab, it is fact as far as I'm concerned. The Jordan 12 comes with a Phylon midsole, and Phylon, if you didn't know, it's essentially a type of foam that Nike invented. It is more responsive and it is more lightweight. And you also see Phylon used on the Jordan 13s and a bunch of other shoes. But this shoe uses Phylon and it also has a full length Zoom Air unit as well as a carbon fiber shank plate. One of my favorite things to put on shoes, carbon fiber, very, very lightweight, but also very strong and durable, provides a lot of support. Love carbon fiber on shoes. And the traction of the shoe, majority herringbone. So I think it still holds up pretty well today. And then on the very top of the outsole, pretty distinct feature of the Jordan 12 again, the Jumpman that extends up the outsole onto the toe box. And this shoe doesn't come with any extra laces, OG colorway, don't really want to change it too much. I think the white laces that come out of the box, works perfect for the shoe. Black laces might actually look pretty nice, but white laces, I think it works perfectly. One thing that I do like to point out for Jordan 12s, you see there's no ventilation on the shoe. There's none. It's just like a sock. So for people that have sweaty feet and will take their shoes off at some point after wearing their shoe for a long time, just think about others. Be more considerate. This shoe, the ventilation, not the greatest. And the box of the shoe, it's a Nike box. I never owned the 97 OG pair of the Jordan 12 Cherries. I barely could speak English at that point. I was super young. So I don't know if this was the box that it came with in 1997. If you know, please let me know in the comments below. But yeah, Nike box. And on the side of the box, it actually says, engineered and built to the exact specifications of championship athletes from around the world. I wonder what kind of box they would engineer for non-championship athletes from around the world. Does that mean every other box that doesn't look like this are for losers like myself? Maybe. Now moving on to size and comfort, I'm a size 9.5 true to size. I do have wide feet, and for Jordan 12s, I generally tend to stick true to size, but I do have to caution wide footers. Out of the box at least, it is a pretty stiff shoe in my experience. Especially this arch area, it comes up pretty high. So if you have wide feet and flat feet, this might be pretty sore, especially out of the box before you break this shoe in, but it never breaks in to the point where like I'm fully satisfied. I still think it can be a pretty stiff shoe for wide footers in that area. Everything else fits pretty well. If I go up half a size in Jordan 12s, I feel like the length is slightly too long. I just prefer sticking true to size. And in terms of the cushioning, because of the carbon fiber shank plate, the full length Zoom Air unit, I think it's got very good cushioning. Performance wise, I think it's very, very decent. Still holds up in 2023. It's a relatively lightweight shoe. As mentioned before, it has a Phylon midsole. So that does have some weight savings compared to like a rubber cup sole. The padding inside is nice and soft. It's sufficient. But for wide footers, it might not be the most comfortable shoe. And again, I have to caution and I have to make a disclaimer. You have to be sure that you have wide feet. Some people think they have wide feet and then compare it to mine. They don't hold a chance. It's not wide. For people that truly do have wide feet, I think this arch area, yeah, it's not perfect. So just keep that in mind. And that brings the total sole score for the Air Jordan 12 Cherry to 14 out of 20. A pretty average score compared to other general releases. Same score as other OGs such as the Jordan 8 as well as the Jordan 2 Chicagos. And I do have to remind people the sole score looks at each metric in a vacuum. It doesn't include kind of unquantifiable metrics like intangibles, which is a huge part of sneakers. Sometimes you just look at a shoe and just love it. No reason, no rhyme or reason to it. You just love the shoe. It doesn't include those kind of metrics. So for OGs like the Jordan 12 Cherries that are beloved, it might not rank as high as you probably thought it would. But again, that's because it's looking at each metric in a vacuum. Just keep that in mind. Now, first metric is colorway. I think the Cherry colorway is very nice. It's super simple, super wearable. You can't really go wrong with a white and red shoe, but it's not my favorite. I gotta be honest. I think there's a lot of other OG colorways that are better than the Cherry colorway. For me, even though I think this is a very clean colorway, it's not my favorite. Now, in terms of materials, like I mentioned before, pretty nice leather, nothing premium, not the best. Definitely seen better leather on other shoes, which is again, kind of disappointing because a lot of people are looking forward and excited for the shoe. But in terms of the tech specs, I think the Jordan 12s are very nice. The herringbone traction, as well as the carbon fiber shank plate, Phylon midsole, full length Zoom Air, all very good features. Now, comfort wise, like I mentioned before, I'm a wide footer. So when it comes to the Jordan 12s, doesn't fit perfectly. The arch, it just kind of gives me some pain and discomfort there. I think for my feet specifically, there's more comfortable Jordans like the Jordan 5s, the 2s, the 13s, the 14s, the Jordan 3s. Now I get that might not be the case for everyone, especially for those that don't have wide feet, but I can only speak to my experience. I think the cushioning and support are nice. It's not the best in terms of comfort, but definitely not the worst. Now in terms of versatility, I think the Jordan 12 silhouette, it does still look like a pretty athletic looking shoe, but when you actually put it on feet, it's actually more wearable than you like might picture it, especially from a bird's eye view. I think it looks classy. There's something about the Jordan 12 silhouette. I think it's more versatile on feet than on images. And this colorway, the versatility of a white and red sneaker doesn't really get much wearable than that. Can't go wrong with a Cherry colorway in terms of versatility. A lot of people, especially sneakerheads from a certain era, have been waiting a long time for this shoe to come back. And I hope they're happy because I think it's a nice shoe and it definitely hits on that nostalgia factor. So that's it. Thanks for watching. Sole Inclined. Let me know what you think of the Air Jordan 12 Cherry. Like, subscribe, comment, all that good stuff. And remember, tomorrow may never come, so wear your shoes.